Hi there, my name is Z, and today we are going to do a review of UFO, Rebuilding Atomizer. So, this is the UFO Rebuilding Atomizer, which I purchased from www.itigara-electronica.ro. Once again, this is the UFO Rebuilding Atomizer, which I purchased from www.itigara-electronica.ro. Now, let's take a closer look. So, this is UFO rebuildable atomizer. His main parts are the plastic tank, of course. This is the cone for the central pin for the needle. This is the middle part of the needle, and this is the coil. So, positive, negative connection. In the middle or between of the coils are the airflow. I'm not sure if you're able to see it, but this here underneath the coil is the airflow. So when you put everything back together, you will see what is it about. Here is the O-ring to prevent leaking. The threads are good, the threading is okay, there is no problem with putting it together. This is the WAPO sign here. It's made from solid brass, I think. It is not stainless steel. Here is the airflow. And this is the standard EGO connection. That means it is, I think it's made for EGO batteries, but there is no problem to put it on the mode with EGO connection or with the 510 anti adapter. So basically, I'm not going to show you how to make the coil or something, because I showed it in the previous videos. I will explain it to you, but I'm not going to do a tutorial or anything. Now let's take it apart and explain what's the problem, because it is a very similar to WAPO King versus One, and I do the tutorial for that already. So the tank can hold up 1.1 milliliter of e-liquid, and of course for proper working of this atomizer, it is very important to know how to make your wick here in the needle. The good thing about this is because there is no need for you to use the mesh, I'm using only the fiber. I put two strings of fiberglass, and of course the fiber needs to touch the coil here on the left and the right side of the needle is the vent holes. So when you put everything together, the air or the vapor goes in that way. Now for the coil. In the center between the positive and negative connection and underneath the coil is the air, let's say, I don't know, tunnel, air hole, something like that. So when the vapor production is on and you start to inhale, it is a very good throw hit and very good, of course vapor production is good. The throw hit should be very strong. I will show it to you. So, of course now there is no liquid on the, see? It is very good vapor production. I'm going to show it to you once again. Just a little bit of liquid here. See. Of course, the trick on the rebuildable atomizer, this is the A type of rebuildable atomizer, is to know how to make the coil and how to make the wick here. The wick should only touch the coil and that is enough to conduct the liquid from the tank to the coil. For the coil, I tried to put it just on one side. It didn't fit very good for me. I tried to put it on the other side, so it didn't fit very good for me. So I decided to put it like this. Positive connection is up to me and the negative connection is turned to you. So it's something like, I don't know, diagonally placed wick. I found that that's very good for me, not just for this atomizer, but for two or three other kind of the atomizer. And when you make the coil like this, it should be okay. Now let's put everything together and let's see how it vapes. Once again, it looks very good on Ego kind of battery. Also it looks okay on mods, but I found it very good on this Ego T upgrade battery, so I will try it on this battery and I'm only going to measure my resistance on Joytech Ebook. Okay, now first I want to see my resistance of this atomizer because I made a coil. So I'm going to put it on my device and the resistance is 1.2 ohms. So this is going to be very good. Okay, now I'm going to fill it up, put it back on the Ego battery and see how it vapes. Okay, for filling it up you may use various tools. I'm going to use a needle and a syringe because I don't have a bottle with a syringe here, so it is very easy to fill it up. There is a hole like every cartridge or tank and just put the tank back. This tank system or these tank systems I found to work very good. I like the vapor production, I like the taste and I like the throat heat. So when you put back the tank on the atomizer, when you take a vape you need to see a bubbles. So see, there was, this is the bubble. I don't know if you are able to see it. So if you are seeing bubbles, it means that the liquid is already on the coil and everything is okay. And if you are not seeing bubbles, everything is not okay. So now let's just take, I don't know, I will show you. See the bubbles? So we saw the bubbles, it means everything is all right. Now let's put it on the Ego battery and see how it vapes. Okay, we'll put UFO back on the ego battery. One very good thing that I've noticed during my test period is the threads of these three parts. It is very good. You're practically not going to see the threads, but you're able to feel them. There is a vapor right in here in the middle, which is now aligned with the button. Okay. Now, and of course it looks very good, Amigo battery. Now, let's see how it vapes. Okay, as you were able to see, the vapor production is very good, but that depends on how you build your coil. My coil is 1.2 ohms, so it is a low resistant coil, but it works on ego battery. The vapor production, of course, is very good. The throat heat is strong, but that depends on e-liquid that you are going to use, and of course the flavor is very good. I am a fan of tank systems, especially rebuildable tank systems. So once again, this was the UFO rebuildable atomizer. I purchased it from www.etcurrent-electronica.ro. You saw basically everything, and okay, if there is any need for tutorial of how to make a coil and everything, try to reach me and I will show it to you in a separate tutorial. Okay, thank you once again for watching the video, and greetings from Belgrade.